In this video, we're going to look at updating and configuring the firmware of a DMX USB Pro. To do this, we're going to use ENTTEC's lighting and control software, EMU. This software is great for performers due to its MIDI, VST and audio integration, alongside any user of ENTTEC's DMX USB products for its inbuilt device configuration. To start, I'm going to head over to the ENTTEC website and then navigate to the DMX USB Pro page. As you can see here, we have two different firmware versions of these products in the download section. You can download both of these for use later. Now, we're going to navigate to the EMU software. Here I've already got a show open that I was working on previously. We're going to head over to the preferences icon at the top right. You can see under the output tab that we have ArtNet Broadcast and our DMX USB Pro already discovered. If you can have multiple, you can check the serial number here. If your device doesn't show up instantly, you can rescan for devices using the blue button. Here we can see that when running the scan, EMU also found an ENTTEC S-Play show controller on the network that's responding to ArtPod. If we pressed on the config gear, this would link us to its webpage in a browser. But more on that in another video. To enable the DMX output on our DMX USB Pro in EMU for any testing, use the Enable tool. You'll see the USB icon light up in the top left corner of the screen. Now to change the device settings and update the firmware, press the configuration icon in the same line as the USB Pro. This will show you all device parameters and allow you to pull them from the device, as well as set them. If using older or fairly cheap fixtures, it can be useful to reduce the refresh rate closer to around 30 frames a second in order to ensure things run smoothly. As for firmware updates, the DMX USB Pro has two firmware versions, one with RDM support and one without. If your fixtures aren't RDM compatible, we recommend using firmware version 1.4. This features no RDM code and it keeps things nice and simple. If you are using DMX and RDM, use version 2.4. These firmware versions can be selected within EMU internally, or you can use files downloaded from the website. Once you select the firmware file you want, you can apply it to the device. As it's doing this, its progress will be shown live. Make sure you never unplug your USB Pro midway through an update. This could lead to it becoming corrupted. If this does happen, the first thing to try in order to restore it is to rediscover it on the previous page, then try and re-upload the firmware again. If you're still running into troubles, get in contact with the ENTTEC support team. After you're happy with the firmware version and its configuration, the window can be closed. You can now use your Pro in EMU, or close EMU and launch any other compatible software. It's important to remember only to run one piece of DMX software with your USB Pro at a time, to avoid multiple pieces of software fighting to control it. We hope this has been helpful. If you've got any questions, leave them in the comments below, or get in touch with the team at ENTTEC.com. See you in the next one.